Bill Gates once said, "I choose a lazy person to do a hard job because a lazy person will find an easy way to do it." I am that lazy person. Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another video tutorial. You'll notice I didn't say LumaFusion video tutorial, and that's because today we're going to be taking a look at an app called Mojo. But let's go back a little bit first of all, and I should clarify by saying I'm not a lazy person per se, although my wife would probably disagree with that. What I mean by this statement, which I think is a brilliant quote, is that I look for the most efficient way of doing something that I can possibly find. And when it comes to motion graphics, my go-to app is called Mojo. Let me show you. Okay, let's launch the app and give you a quick tour. Now, Mojo as an app is designed for creating amazing Instagram stories, but it's so much more because the animations that come with all the different templates and the graphics and the effects that you can apply to titles, captions, social media, links, that kind of thing, are just absolutely stunning. Okay, let me show you how I go about creating a motion graphic for LumaFusion from scratch. Come down to the create from scratch option. You can either tap the blank option here in the bottom left hand corner, or what I tend to do is just tap on landscape, and that way I get the correct format for working with LumaFusion. Now you'll notice most of the options here say pro on them. I do pay for the pro options, and that obviously gives me greater flexibility, but you can download this app completely for free and use just the story option and then just crop out the bits and pieces that you don't want to use. The pro option though gives you the ability to install your own fonts, install your own logos, full access to all the templates plus all the new templates that they bring in, and obviously all the different formats that you can see here. But you can get away with just using the free version. It's up to you. So I'm just going to tap on landscape. I'm then going to tap on the placeholder, and I've got a simple chroma key graphic that's just at 4K size, but I don't even need it at 4K size, but it's at 4K size anyway. Click done. And then from there, we're going to tap the plus symbol in the bottom right hand corner. And I'm then going to go to text, and we're in the title section, but I'll just give you a brief look at some of the other options you've got available to you, of which there's a lot going on. Special one's really interesting as well, as you can see here. Fallouts and things like that, and also the numbers, which I really like actually. If you're ever doing a graphic that you need to specify, like sort of a pie chart or a bar chart, whatever you type in value wise is what it will show you in the actual graphic. And for example, the followers thing down here is quite cool as well. I'm just going to go back into it, text, scroll down to nearly the bottom because I want to use a big title. We'll drop that in there. I'm just going to pinch and zoom, get it up to a size that I want to fill the majority of the left hand side. Next thing I want to do is change it to white because that's more appropriate to what I need. And then I'm just going to double tap on big, and I'm just going to put a Mojo. I'll type in here tutorial. There we go. I need to obviously reposition it again, so just tap and highlight it and move it about. You'll see an automatic guide comes up for the middle, and you could lock it off directly into the middle if you want it equidistant. I tend to want to just offset it ever so slightly. And then if we just tap on the outside edge, you can see the overall effect. If you want to, you can go in and adjust any of the effects in terms of changing the format, the duration of the title. So for example, this is set to 5.8 seconds. If I didn't want it to be 5.8 seconds, I'd switch over to manual. I could bring it up to like 7 seconds, or I can bring it down to 4.8 seconds, whatever you want to do, and then just tap done. And once you're ready, just tap save in the top right hand corner. This will give you some options. Obviously this app's completely geared up for posting to Instagram, but you can just tap on save video and that will save it to your photos app. Click done. And that's us. We're now ready to go back to LumaFusion. Okay, once we're back in LumaFusion, I've got a clip loaded up of Varanasi. I hope that's the right pronunciation in India. Just as a little sort of stock grab, and I'm going to assume that's the River Ganges, but I could be wrong. Somebody can correct me in the comments if they want to. I've got that there. And then we want to highlight mojovideo.mp4. That's what the file gets named as. And then if we just play that through, you can see the effect there. And all we have to do is just drag and drop that onto our timeline. We'll move it along ever so slightly. And then obviously what we need to do is go into our color and effects, go to our little key icon for chroma key, and then just tap on green screen key, and that will knock things out straight away. And then all I'm going to do is just go to the complete option, and I like to just take the edge blur radius down a little bit so they've got a little bit of a crisper edge. Sometimes you've got to watch for that. I don't think there's any need to adjust anything else at this point. So very, very simple chroma key adjustment. Tap back and then you can just see and you can play it through. It's as simple as that. And obviously you could put a sound effect in there, your background music, whatever you want, no problem at all. And that works on 100% of the different Mojo motion graphic titles, captions, and different options that you want to maybe apply. There is another way of doing things, which I'll take you on next, which is to obviously just take a video clip and directly work with it in Mojo. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so we're back in Mojo, and this time, rather than starting with a blank template, I'm going to start with one of their pre-setup templates. Again, what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to go in and make an edit first of all, and I want to change the format. I'm going to change it to square, and then from there I'm going to tap on the placeholder in the background. And I did this little motion art for my Instagram last night, and you can see the effect it's creating. The designs, I would say, are always set up for Instagram stories. So you'll notice, for example, if I just tap on this little arrow option here, gets squidged out the way and you've got to kind of bring it down. I actually don't need this, I'm just going to trash it, and all I want is the text. So I'm just going to say Mojo again tutorial, click done, adjust the text and see it playing through, and there's the overall effect with the glitch in that. Now, if I didn't want it that shape, I could go back into format and put it back into a landscape format and just readjust the positioning of it. See the overall effect there, and then I can just save this out. So rather than doing a chroma key, we're actually bringing the video clip in. Tap done, and if we go back into our timeline, get rid of that stuff there, and you can just bring down the clip itself and then just play it through, and you'll see there's the overall effect. If you guys want, I'll do a lot more video tutorials on the Mojo app, and obviously including it into LumaFusion. Just let me know in the comments below and I'll certainly do that for you. I'm only just scratching the surface of what Mojo can actually do, as it's a very, very powerful app. And I have done a previous video a couple of years ago on Mojo, and you can check that out if you want to sort of see a sort of broader version of what the Mojo app can do. Although the app has been considerably updated since I did that video tutorial, so just be aware that you're looking at an older version. But it gives you the broad strokes of what's going on. There we go. As you can see, Mojo tutorial. Or we can drag down another video clip and put in our original title over the top. And then once again, go to color and effects and just quickly key it out, reduce the edge blur, and you can see that effect being applied. So either way works really, really well, and I use both. It just depends on what I'm doing. I tend to find if I'm going to use a motion graphic more than once on a video, like it might be like a title that I've created for a client or whatever, then I'll use the green screen option. If I'm just doing a one-off thing that I want to slot in quickly, then I'll just bring the video directly into Mojo and work it from there. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed this video tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe, all those good YouTube things, and I will catch you on the next one. Bye.